So, stories by Rudyard Kipling. How the Whale Got His Throat. In the sea, once upon a time, oh my best beloved, there was a whale, and he ate fishes. He ate the starfish, and the garfish, and the crab, and the crab, and the dab, and the plaice, and the dace, and the skates, and his mate, and the mackerel, and the pickerel, and the really truly twirly whirly eel. All the fishes he could find in the sea, he ate with his mouth. So, till at last, there was only one small fish left in all the sea, and he was a small astute fish and swam a little behind the whale right here so as to be out of harm's way. And then the whale stood upon his tail and said, I'm hungry. And the small astute fish said in a small astute voice, noble and generous cetacean, have you ever tasted man? No, said the whale. What is it like? Nice, said the small astute fish. Nice, sir, but nubbly. Then fetch me some, said the whale, and he made the sea froth up with his tail. Oh, one at a time is enough. If you swim to latitude 50 north, longitude 40 west, that is magic. You will find sitting on a raft in the middle of the sea with nothing to wear except a pair of blue canvas breeches, a pair of suspenders. You must particularly remember the suspenders, best beloved, and a jackknife. One shipwrecked mariner. Who is only fair to tell you, is a man of infinite resource and sagacity. So the whale swam and swam to latitude 50 north and longitude 40 west, as fast as he could swim, and on a raft in the middle of the sea, with nothing to wear except a pair of blue canvas breeches, a pair of suspenders. You must particularly remember the suspenders, best beloved, and a jackknife. He found one single solitary shipwrecked mariner, trailing from his toes in the water. He had his mummy's leave to paddle, or else he would never have done it, because he was a man of infinite resource and sagacity. Then the whale opened his mouth back and back and back and back, till it nearly touched his tail, and he swallowed the shipwrecked mariner, and the raft he was sitting on, and his blue canvas breeches, and the suspenders, which you must not forget, and the jackknife. He swallowed them all down into his warm, dark inside cupboards, and then he smacked his lips, and turned round three times on his tail. But as soon as the mariner, who is a man of infinite resource and sagacity, found himself truly inside the whale's warm, dark inside cupboards, he stumped, and he jumped, and he thumped, and he bumped, and he pranced, and he danced, and he banged, and he clanged, and he hit, and he bit, and he leaped, and he creeped, and he prowled, and he howled, and he hopped, and he rocked, and he cried, and he sighed, and he pulled, and he pulled, and he stepped, and he leapt, and he danced hornpipes where he shouldn't, and the whale felt most unhappy indeed. Have you forgotten the suspenders? So he said to the stew fish, this man is very numbly, and besides, he's making me hiccup. Hop, hop! What shall I do? Hop, hop! Tell him to come out, said the small stew fish. So the whale called down his throat to the shipwrecked mariner. Come out and behave yourself. I got the hiccups. Hop, hop! Nay, nay, said the mariner. Not so, but far other ways. Take me to my natal shore and the white cliffs of Albion, and I'll think about it. And he began to dance more than ever. Oh, you'd better take him home, said the stew fish. I ought to have warned you that he is a man of infinite resource and sagacity. So the whale swam and swam with both flippers and his tail for the hiccups. And at last he found the mariner's little shore and the white cliffs of Albion, and he opened his mouth wide and wide and wide and said, change here for Winchester, Nashua, Nashua, Keene, and stationed on the Fitchburg Road. And just as he said, "Fitch," the murmur walked out of his mouth. But while the whale had been swimming, the murmur was indeed a person of infinite resource and sagacity. Had taken his jackknife and cut up the raft into a little square grating, all running crisscross, and he tied it firm with his suspenders. Now you know why you will not forget the suspenders. And he dragged that grating good and tight into the whale's throat, and there it stuck. Then he recited the following sloka, which, as you've not heard it, I will now proceed to relate. "By means of a grating, I've stopped your eating." For a murmur, he was also an Iberian. And he stepped out on the shingle and went home to his mother, who'd given him leave to trail his toes in the water. And he married and lived happily ever after. So did the whale. But from that day on, the grating in his throat, which he could neither cough up nor swallow down, prevented him from eating anything except a very, very small fish. And that is the reason why whales for nowadays never eat men or boys or little girls. The small, astute fish went and hid himself in the mud under the doorsills of the equator. He was afraid that the whale might be angry with him. The sailor took the jackknife home. He was wearing the blue Kenneth breeches when he walked out on the shingle. The suspenders were left behind, you see, to tie the grating with. And that's the end. That tale. Done. Now can I watch it?